drove in that road there this morning, and the snow seemed pretty solid, so I just kept going as far as I could, and then dumped my pack and snowshoes, and turned around, and I drove back the other way, probably 2 miles, and left the truck. And I'm going hiking for a couple nights in East Lewis County, Washington. And I did not want to leave the truck here because this is about 2 foot deep of snow, and it could melt anytime, turn into a bunch of slush, and I'd be stuck here for a long time. So I'm gonna head up this old road. There's a big lake up ahead, about 5 miles, so we'll go to that lake and camp out for a couple days. Lots of tracks in the snow today. We got blue skies, sunshine. That's Mount Rainier. The valley below is Packwood and the Cowlitz River. This is Packwood Lake, and there's a island smack in the middle of it. Lake's froze over. There's a mountain back there. That's Johnson Peak. And up in the saddle, you can just make out the Cascade Crest Trail. Here's the old Forest Service cabin. I don't think anybody stays up here anymore. There used to be a resort. They had a little store, ranger cabin, and they had a boat rental, a dock with rowboats you could rent. But they tore all that out and made this area part of the wilderness. You can see where that elk walked across this bridge, and he was rubbing his belly, getting high centered. These elk up here have just been tearing up the trails. This is a main branch, goes up to Three Peaks Trail and Coyote Trail. Looks like the elk are using both of them. I'm gonna try to set up a camp here. Maybe use this log as a wind stop and fill in down below it, and somehow get my tarp draped over the top of it. I got water close by, snow's not deep, so I can just shovel it out of the way, and we'll get a small fire going so we can cook dinner. And I'll have the sun in the evening, should be able to get decent sun by maybe 9 or 10 in the morning. So this will be my spot. Okay, so I got everything underneath the log filled in with snow. for a windbreak. Cleared off most of the snow where my bed and fire will be. So I'll find some sticks and boughs for a bed. I got a little windbreak here started too. Might not need one here. So this trip I have a Sierra, what is this, some bivy sack, thin Therm-a-Rest for summer, another mattress there, and a 20 degree Wiggies sleeping bag. Yeah, way too thin bow bed, but there are not many bows here, or sticks, so. I'll probably take all my other gear and put underneath me too. I'll put my backpack, whatever I have, just so this be my pillow. That's my bed. I'm out looking for firewood and I just found this spine from an elk hanging by fish line in the trees. It's a little different. That just means there's elk here. There's good hunting. It's a good sign. The water's boiling. Time for some chili mac. Okay, there's a chili mac. And I'm gonna have some hot chocolate, boiled chocolate. It's that Mexican chocolate. It's pretty good stuff. As soon as that cooks up, I'm gonna start burning. I'm gonna burn the pot rack and everything. That's my firewood. It's too dark to find any. So, we'll have more time tomorrow. Morning. I slept pretty good and stayed warm inside this Wiggy sleeping bag, but I notice I have frost inside of my bivy sack. Ice, frost, everything inside the bivy sack is frozen. Everything inside the Wiggies is warm and dry. My boot liners I kept inside my bivy sack underneath my sleeping bag just for added insulation. It seems to have dried them out pretty good. They're warm. So I'll have some warm boots to put on in the morning. Not frozen, hopefully. Found a bird nest, but it's frozen solid. It was wet. It's like a block of ice. But we'll burn it up anyway. There's not much firewood here at all. Most everything is green wood. And the lower dead branches have been picked by people camping during the summer. Found some cedar. Use for tinder. We did get enough lower branches to get a fire started. I'm gonna have potatoes, onions, and bacon fried up for breakfast. This is that salt dried bacon. I've been eating on the same chunk for 3 months now. 1 pound lasts probably 8 days. This is yellow cedar. It's frozen. Just look how tight the growth rings are in that. It's an old tree. It's only about 8 inch diameter. Bundle for tomorrow morning's breakfast. We got this witch's hair that's dry. I've had it drying by the fire. I got some cedar here. In there too. I'm just gonna let that sit around the fire and dry. It's bone dry, so I just throw a flame and maybe even a spark to it in the morning and have a quick fire. I got some wood split up for tonight's dinner, and I got just enough wood for tomorrow morning's breakfast. I got some cedar split up for kindling. Got a tinder bundle drying out, ready for the morning. And my clothes are, they've been hanging down there in the sun. But the sun is almost gone, so I'm gonna go get those rounded up and get my bed ready. And then cook some dinner. Sun's gone down over the ridge. This is second night. Breakfast, we're having bacon and pancakes. I got some blackberry jam and peanut butter and a bag of cranberries to put in the pancakes. Clouds are back. All the ice is cracking and popping. Things warmed up quite a bit. So it's time to head home. I hope my truck's still there. Clouds are back and that's Packwood down in the bottom. Mount Rainier's back in there. And I've got about 2 more miles up this road before I get to my truck. Truck's still there. All right, I gotta go home.